Welcome on my channel Crochet with Joanna. Today I'm going to show you another doily project. This time it's gonna be doily with flower motif inside. My project is measured about 16 inches in diameter. I'm using crochet hooks as 1.5 millimeters and crochet thread in size. Then for this project we are going to use a little bit less than 50 gram, so one ball should be enough. At the beginning I would like to tell you that this project is very tight, so by working our runs with chain spaces our project is going to start waving. So basically at the end we need to use hot iron and even we need to block this project to have exactly the same effect at the end as I've got right now. So don't worry, as I said, the project is very tight but it's worth to make it. At the end it looks exactly as mine. So let's get started. We are going to start with slip knot, then chain of 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now slip stitch in our first chain stitch to form a ring, and we are going to start first round. Chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then into the ring we are going to make another 11 double crochets, so in total we should have 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And 11. After our last double crochet, now we have to work slip stitch at the top of third chain, so at the top of our first double crochet. So 12 double crochets in our circle. Second round, we are going to start by making chain 1 and single crochet in exactly the same stitch as we've done slip stitch. And now chain of 3, single crochet in next double crochet, chain 3, single crochet in next double crochet, chain 3, then single crochet in next double crochet, chain 3. So this pattern now we have to repeat all the way around. In each double crochet from our previous round we have to work single crochet, then chain of 3. So at the end of this round we should have 12 single crochets and 12 chain 3 spaces. After our last chain 3 space we need to work slip stitch into the first single crochet. Our third round we are going to start by making slip stitch in our first two chain stitches, then chain 1 and single crochet in our first chain 3 space. Chain of 3, then single crochet in next chain space, and again chain of 3, single crochet in next chain space. Chain 3, single crochet in next chain space, chain 3, single crochet in next chain space. So now this pattern we are going to repeat all the way around. So again, in each chain space one single crochet, then chain 3. At the end we should have another 12 single crochets and 12 chain 3 spaces, and round number 4 we are going to repeat in exactly the same way. So after slip stitch in our first single crochet we need to work slip stitch in first two chain stitches, then single crochet in our first chain 3 space and chain 3 again, single crochet in each next chain 3 and chain 3 after each single crochet. So at the end of our round 3 and 4 we have to work slip stitch into the first single crochet. Round number 5 we are going to start by making slip stitch in first two chain stitches, then chain of 3 as a first double crochet. Now into the same chain stitch we need to make another 2 double crochets. 1 and 2. Chain of 2. So we've got 3 double crochets in one chain stitch. Now we have to go to the next chain space and into the second chain stitch we are going to make another 3 double crochets. 1, 2 and 3. Chain of 2, then into the next second chain stitch 3 double crochets. 1, 2 and 3. Chain of 2, and this pattern now we are going to repeat all the way around. So in each second chain stitch of each chain 3 space we have to work 3 double crochets, then chain of 2. At the end we should have 12 groups of 3 double crochets and 12 chain 2 spaces. After last chain 2 space we have to work slip stitch at the top of our first double crochet. Round number 6 we are going to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet. Then into the same stitch we have to work one more double crochet. So we've got 2 double crochets in our first stitch. Then 1 double crochet into the second. And 2 double crochets into the third again. So 2 double crochets in first one. 1 double crochet in second. And 2 double crochets in third. Now we've got group of 5 double crochets. Chain of 2. Then we need to repeat. 2 double crochets in first double crochet, 1 double crochet in second, then 2 double crochets in third. So we've got another group of 5 double crochets. Chain of 2. And this pattern now you need to repeat all the way around. So 2 double crochets in first double crochet, 1 double crochet in second, and 2 double crochets in third. Chain of 2. So we should have now 12 groups of 5 double crochets and 12 chain 2 spaces. Round number 7 we are going to start by making chain of 2 instead of the first part of the double crochet. Then into the next stitch we have to work 1 double crochet. So this is count as a 2 double crochets together. So at the end of our round we are going to make slip stitch, or actually double crochet, in our first double crochet. Chain 2 we need to skip. Now 1 double crochet in next double crochet, and in our last 2 stitches we have to make 2 double crochets together. So through first 2 loops 1 and through first 2 loops 1. Now we've got 3 loops, we need to finish the stitch. Chain of 5. And we are going directly to the next group of 5 double crochets. Now we need to repeat. In first 2 double crochets we have to work 2 double crochets together. So 1 and 2. We've got 3 loops, now we can finish the stitch. In next double crochet 1 double crochet. And then in next 2 stitches 2 double crochets together. So 1 and 2. 3 loops, we can finish the stitch. Chain of 5. This pattern now we need to repeat all the way around. So in first 2 double crochets 2 double crochets together. In next double crochet 1 double crochet. And in next 2 2 double crochets together again. So we should have 3 stitches, 3 double crochets, and then chain of 5. At the end of our round, instead of our last chain of 5, we are going to make chain of 2 and then double crochet in our first full double crochet. So as I said before, chain 2 from the beginning we need to skip. Now we are going to start round number 8. So our previous round, as I said before, we have to finish by making chain of 2 and double crochet in our first full double crochet. So chain 2 we need to skip. Now chain 1 and into our chain space we are going to make 3 single crochets. 1, 2 and 3. 1 single crochet at the top of our first group of 2 double crochets together. Then we have to skip another double crochet, and into the second group of two double crochets together we have to work two double crochets, one and two. In next chain 5 space we are going to make 10 double crochets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. In our first group of two double crochets together we have to make two double crochets, 1 and 2. So before our group of 10 double crochets in chain 5 space we've got group of two double crochets, and after. Now we need to skip next double crochet, and into the second group of two double crochets we have to work single crochet, and into chain 5 space 5 single crochets, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So this is mean that at the end of our round we have to work another two single crochets in our first chain space, then slip stitch in first single crochet. Now single crochet at the top of the first group of two double crochets together, and then we have to skip second double crochet, and into the next group of two double crochets we have to work two double crochets again, and another 10 double crochets in chain 5 space. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Two double crochets in first group of two double crochets together, 1 and 2. So in a row we should have 14 double crochets. And now again we have to skip the second double crochet, into the next group of two double crochets together we have to work one single crochet, then 5 single crochets in chain space, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Single crochet in first group, so we should have 7 single crochets in a row. And now again we have to skip second double crochet, into the next one 2 double crochets, then 10 double crochets in chain space, and another 2 double crochets in first group, then into the last one single crochet, 5 single crochets in chain space, and single crochet in first one. So in each second chain space we have to work with 10 double crochets, and in each second chain space we have to work with 5 single crochets. So now we need to repeat this pattern all the way around. So one time we are going to start with single crochets in our last group of 2 double crochets, and the next time with 2 double crochets. Round number 9. After slip stitch in our first single crochet, which is third single crochet in our chain space, we are going to start with three double crochets. But first of all, we need to work chain 3 as a first one, then into the same stitch another 2 single crochets. 1 and 2. Now chain of 2. And we have to skip 4 single crochets, our next 4 single crochets, plus first double crochet. Into the second double crochet we have to work single crochet, now chain of 3. Now we have to skip next double crochet, into the second single crochet, chain 3. Then we have to skip next double crochet, into the second single crochet, chain 3. Then in the middle we have to skip 2 double crochets, single crochet in third one, chain 3. Now we have to skip 1 double crochet, into the second single crochet, chain 3. And we have to skip another double crochet, into the second single crochet. So here we need to skip 1, then 1, in the middle 2, then 1 and another 1. Now chain of 2 and we are going to skip our last double crochet, then next 4, then next 3 single crochets into the 4th one, 3 double crochets. So from now we are going to repeat our pattern from the beginning. So after 3rd double crochet, now we need to make chain of 2, then we have to skip another 3 single crochets, 1st double crochet, single crochet in, 2nd double crochet, chain 3, skip 1st one, single crochet in 2nd, chain 3, skip 1st one into the 2nd single crochet, chain 3. Now we have to skip 2 double crochets into the 2nd, into the 3rd single crochet, chain 3. Now we have to skip 1 into the 2nd single crochet, chain 3. Then we have to skip 1 into the 2nd chain 3. So again, we have to skip 1, 1, 2, 1 and 1. So at the beginning I said that we have to skip 4 single crochets. No, we have to skip 3 single crochets on both sides because we've got group of 7 single crochets in a row. And from now we need to repeat again, so chain of 2. Now we need to skip last double crochet, first 3 single crochets and into the 4th one, 3 double crochets. So this is our whole pattern. Each time after group of 3 double crochets, we need to work 5 chain 3 spaces and at the end of our round we have to work slip stitch in first double crochet. Round number 10. We are going to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then double crochet into the same stitch. So we've got 2 double crochets in first one, 1 double crochet into the second and another 2 double crochets in third one. So we've got group of 5 double crochets. Now chain of 2, then we are going to the first chain 3 space, single crochet. Now chain of 3, single crochet in next chain space, chain 3, single crochet in next chain space, chain 3, then into the next chain 3 and into the our last one. So in this round we've got 4 chain 3 spaces. Now chain of 2 and we are going to repeat 2 double crochets in first double crochet, 1 double crochet in second, then 2 double crochets in last one. Chain of 2, single crochet in first chain 3 space and again we need to work 4 chain 3 spaces as we've done in this part. And this pattern now we are going to repeat all the way around. After our last chain of 2, slip stitch in first double crochet. Round 11, we are going to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then into the same stitch we need to make one more double crochet. Double crochet into the next double crochet, then into the third one we have to work double crochet, chain 1 and one more double crochet. In next double crochet, double crochet, then into our last 2 double crochets, 1 and 2. Chain of 2, now we have to go directly to chain 3 space, single crochet, chain 3, single crochet in next chain space, chain 3, single crochet in next chain space, chain 3, then single crochet in next chain space, chain of 2 and from now we are going to repeat. So in first double crochet we have to work 2 double crochets, in next double crochet 1 double crochet, into the third one we need to work V stitch, so double crochet, chain 1 and then double crochet. one double crochet in next double crochet, then two double crochets in last one. Chain of two, then we have to go to the first chain three space, single crochet, then chain three, single crochet in next chain space, chain of three, single crochet in next, and one more time chain of three, single crochet in last. So now we've got three chain three spaces, and as you can see, we've got group of four double crochets, chain one, and another group of four double crochets. After our last chain two, we have to work slip stitch in third chain stitch of our first double crochet. Round number 12, we are going to start by making chain of three as a first double crochet, then one double crochet in next three stitches. One, two, and three. Now chain of three, then one double crochet in next four double crochets. One, two, three, and four. Chain of two, single crochet in chain three, then chain three, single crochet in next chain three space, then chain three, then single crochet in last chain three space. So we've got two chain three spaces. Chain of two, then we are going to the next group with four double crochets, and we have to work one double crochet in each stitch. So from now actually we need to repeat what we have done from the beginning of our round. So after fourth double crochet, now chain of three and one double crochet in next four stitches. One, two, three, and four. Chain of two, single crochet in chain three space, chain three, single crochet in next chain three space, chain three, and single crochet in last chain three space, chain of two, and again we have to work one double crochet in next four double crochets, chain three, one double crochet in next four double crochets, chain two, two chain three spaces, and another chain two. So now we need to repeat this pattern all the way around. Round number 13, we are going to start by making chain of three as a first double crochet, and now we need to make one double crochet in next four stitches, three stitches, one, two, and three. Chain of three, then into the second chain stitch of our chain three space, we have to work five double crochets and four chain one spaces. So I've got my first double crochet, chain one, now second, chain one, third, chain one, fourth, chain one, and fifth. Chain of three, then into the next four stitches, next four double crochets, one double crochet in each stitch. One, two, three, and four. Chain of two, then we have to go to our first chain three space, single crochet, now chain of three, and single crochet in next chain space, chain of two, then we are going to repeat our pattern. So one double crochet in next four double crochets, one, two, three, and four. Chain of three, then into the second chain stitch, again five double crochets and four chain one spaces. So the same as we've done here, and this pattern now we are going to repeat all the way around. So now we've got only one chain three space. Round number 14, we are going to start by making chain of three as a first double crochet, then two more double crochets in the same stitch, one and two. one double crochet in next three double crochets, one, two, and three. Chain of three, single crochet into the double crochet, chain three, single crochet in next double crochet, chain three, single crochet in next double crochet, chain three, single crochet in next one, chain three, and single crochet in next. Chain of three. Now we need to work one double crochet in our first three double crochets. One, two, and three. Then three double crochets in the last one. One, two, and three. Double crochet in chain three space. So we are going to skip chain two on both sides. So after our three double crochets, we went directly to the chain three, and now we need to go directly to the next double crochet. And from now we are going to repeat what we've done from the beginning. So three double crochets in our first double crochet, then one double crochet in next three double crochets, and now chain of three. Then we need to go to our first double crochet, then chain three, single crochet in next double crochet. So the same as we've done before. Now we should have four groups of three. We should have four chain three spaces, then chain of three again, three double crochets, then three double crochets in our last stitch, one double crochet, three double crochets in first stitch, and then one double crochet in next three. So this is mean that at the end we need to work three double crochets in our last double crochet in chain three space, and then slip stitch in our first double crochet. Round number 15, we are going to start by making chain of three as a first double crochet, then one double crochet in next two double crochets, one and two. In our next three double crochets, we need to work three double crochets together. So through first two loops, one, in next stitch, two. So each time last loop need to stay on the hook, and three. When we've got four loops, we can finish the stitch. Now chain of three. Single crochet in first chain three space, chain three, single crochet in next one, chain three, single crochet in next, chain three, then into the next, chain three, into the next, chain three, and into the last one. But one more time, chain of three. And we should have seven chain three spaces after our group of three double crochets together. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and this is the seventh. Now in our first three double crochets, so as we've got one in each double crochet from the previous round, we have to work three double crochets together again. So before our seven chain three spaces and after our chain three spaces, that is just next to it, we need to work three double crochets together. Now one double crochet in next seven double crochets, so in next three of this group, two and three, then double crochet in next double crochet, and one double crochet in next three. One, two, and three. In last three double crochets, we have to work three double crochets together again. Now we are before our seven chain three spaces, so we've got group of three double crochets together, and we are going to repeat chain of three, single crochet in first chain space, chain three, single crochet in next chain space, and to the end, to the last chain space. So after our seventh chain three space, we need to work another group of three double crochets together, then 7 double crochets in a row. And this pattern now we are going to continue all the way around. Round number 16, we need to start by making slip stitch in next double crochet. To our first double crochet, we need to go back at the end of this round. At the moment, we need to start with chain 2 as the first part of the double crochet. Into the next two stitches, we have to work only the first part of the double crochet. So we are working through first two loops, last loop need to stay on the hook. And at the top of our three double crochets together as well. So we've got three loops, we can finish the stitch, and we've got group of three double crochets together. Now chain of 3, single crochet in our first chain 3 space, chain 3, single crochet in next chain 3 space, chain 3, single crochet in next one, chain 3, single crochet in next, chain 3, single crochet in next, chain 3, single crochet in next. So we should have 8 chain 3 spaces, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, now 7, single crochet in the last chain 3 space from the previous round, and one more chain 3, so we've got 8 chain 3 spaces. In first 3 stitches, so the first one is a group of 3 double crochets together, we have to work again, first part of the double crochet in each stitch. When we've got 4 loops on our hook, we can finish the stitch. So we've got first group of 3 double crochets together. In next 3 double crochets, we have to work exactly the same. So through first 2 loops, 1, 2, and 3, 4 loops, we need to finish the stitch, and again, 1, 2, and 3. 4 loops, we can finish the stitch. So by working this way, we've got 3 groups of 3 double crochets together. And from now we are going to repeat. Chain of 3, single crochet in first chain 3 space, chain 3, single crochet in next, and again, chain of 3 until the last chain space. So we should have 8 chain 3 spaces again. Then we need to repeat with 3 groups of 3 double crochets together, and at the end we have to work the last 2 groups. So we are going to start from 3 double crochets together and then next 2 stitches, then 2 double crochets, and this one as we had to skip at the beginning of our round. At the end, after the last 1 group, we have to work slip stitch at the top of our first one. At the beginning of our round 17, we need to go back to the first group of 3 double crochets together, so we need to make slip stitch into our 2 previous stitches. First one and the second. So as you can see, we need to insert our crochet hook into the previous stitch and then into the first group of 3 double crochets together. From the first group, we are going to start round 17, and we need to make chain of 2 instead of the first part of the double crochet. Then into the next 2 stitches, we need to work exactly the same. Second stitch is quite hard to see, so we need to insert crochet hook anyway. And then into the last one. When we've got 3 loops on our hook, we can finish the stitch, and we are going to work with chain 3 and single crochet in each chain space from our previous round. So the same as we've done in our previous round. So I'm going to start counting chain 3 spaces. So I've done 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and the last one, the 9th. So we've got 9 chain 3 spaces, and then we are going to the next 3 groups of 3 double crochets together. Now in each stitch we have to work only the first part of the double crochet, so this means that we are making 3 double crochets together again, but this time only one group. And again, chain of 3, single crochet in chain 3 space, chain 3, single crochet in next chain space, and we have to continue until our last, so we should have 9 chain 3 spaces again, and then one group of 3 double crochets together. Round number 18, after slip stitch at the top of our 2 double crochets together, because chain 2 we are going to skip, we need to start by making slip stitch in first chain stitch, then slip stitch in chain space. Now chain 1, single crochet in our chain 3 space, and now chain of 3. Single crochet in next chain space, chain 3. Single crochet in next chain space, then chain 3 again. Single crochet in next one, chain 3, then into the next. And basically in this round we are going to work single crochet in each chain space from our previous round and then chain 3. So we are going to skip our groups of 3 double crochets together. We have to work single crochet in this chain space, then chain 3, and single crochet in next chain 3 space, and continue this pattern all the way around. Now we are going to start round number 19. So in exactly the same way as we've done in our previous one, we need to work slip stitch in first chain stitch of first chain 3 space, then slip stitch into the chain space, chain 1, and single crochet in chain space. Now chain of 3, single crochet in next chain space, chain 3, then single crochet in next one, chain 3, then single crochet in next chain space. And we have to continue all the way around. Then round number 20, 21 and 22, we have to work in exactly the same way. So we supposed to do now 4 rounds with chain 3 spaces, and I will be go back to you at the beginning of round 23. Now we've got round 23, and we have to, after slip stitch in our first single crochet, we need to go directly to the next 2 chain stitches, and we have to work slip stitch as well. So we are going to start from the center of our first chain 3 space. My doily is not lying completely flat at the moment, so don't worry if you've got exactly the same. This is happening because we've done so many rounds with the same number of chain stitches, but later on everything's supposed to be as normal. So we need to start our round 23 by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then into the same stitch we have to work 2 more double crochets, 1 and 2. Now chain of 2, then we have to go to the second chain stitch of the next chain space, and we need to work exactly the same, so 3 double crochets, 1, 2 and 3. Chain of 2, then into the next second chain stitch of the next chain space, 3 double crochets, 1, two and 3, then chain of 2. And this is our whole pattern. So in each second chain stitch of each chain space we have to work group of 3 double crochets, then chain 2. At the end, after our last chain 2 space, we have to work slip stitch in third chain stitch of our first double crochet. Now we are going to start round 24 by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then 1 double crochet in next 2 double crochets, 1 and 2. Chain of 2, 1 double crochet in next 3 double crochets, 1, 2 and 3, then chain of 2. 1 double crochet in next 3 double crochets, 1, 2 and 3, then chain of 2. Double crochet in next 3 double crochets, 1, 2 and 3, then chain of 2. So now we are going to repeat this pattern all the way around. So again, we should have groups of 3 double crochets and chain 2 spaces. Next round, round 25, we need to work with similar way. So we are going to make another groups of 3 double crochets, but between we should work 3 chain stitches. So groups of 3 double crochets and chain 3 spaces between. Now we've got chain of 2, the same as we've had in our previous round, and next one with chain 3. Round 26. We are going to start by making slip stitch in next 2 double crochets. Now chain of 2 and double crochet into the first double crochet. So this is count as a 2 double crochets together. Now chain of 3. Now we have to skip first the double crochet and into our last one we have to work first part of the double crochet, then we need to skip chain space and into the next double crochet, first part of the double crochet as well. 3 loops, we can finish the stitch. Chain of 3. Now we have to skip first double crochet, into the third one we have to work only the first part, then chain 3 we need to skip, and in next double crochet, first part of the double crochet as well. 3 loops, we can finish the stitch. So far we've done 3 groups of 2 double crochets together, chain 3 between. Now chain of 3 again in our third double crochet. So the center one always we have to skip. We need to work single crochet, then chain 5. And single crochet into the next double crochet. So this middle double crochet and the chain spaces actually we have to skip all the time. After our second single crochet, now chain of 3, and we are going to repeat our pattern. So in third double crochet we have to work first part of the double crochet, then in next first one, first part of the double crochet again. 3 loops, we can finish the stitch. And chain 3. In third double crochet, first part of the double crochet, and in next first part of the double crochet again. 3 loops, we can finish the stitch, chain of 3, and again into the third one and into the first one of the next group. 3 loops, we can finish the stitch. So after our chain 5, we've got another 3 groups of 2 double crochets together, and now chain of 3, single crochet in our third double crochet, chain of 5, single crochet in next double crochet, chain 3, and we have to work another 3 groups of 2 double crochets together. So third one, first one, double crochet. And this pattern now we need to repeat all the way around. At the end of my round 26, I've done some modifications because basically the pattern is a little bit different. Instead of 3 groups of 2 double crochets together, 2 times we need to work 4. So basically all the time we are working with 3 groups, but because I had a little bit more space, I decided to work 2 times with 4 groups of 2 double crochets together. So we need to continue with this pattern, but after chain 5 I've got 4, then another chain 5 and another 4 groups, then our last chain 5. So now round 27, we are going to start with chain of 2 instead of the first part of the double crochet, then double crochet into the second group. So we've got 2 double crochets together again. Now chain of 3 into the same stitch, so into the second group, we have to work first part of the double crochet again, and then we are going directly to the third one. Now first part of the double crochet as well. We've got 3 loops, now we can finish the stitch. So we've got 2 groups of 2 double crochets together and between chain 3 space. Now chain of 3. We are going directly to the chain 5 space and we have to work treble crochet, then chain 2. treble crochet, chain 2, treble crochet, chain 2, and we need to work actually 6 treble crochets and 5 chain 2 spaces. I've got 3, now 4, five and six. After the 6th treble crochet, chain of 3, and we are going to repeat our pattern from the beginning. So first part of the double crochet at the top of the first group, then first part of the double crochet at the top of our second group. Now we've got 3 loops, we can finish the stitch. Chain of 3, one more first part of the double crochet in the same stitch, so second part, and then we are going to the third group and we have to work first part as well. 3 loops, we can finish the stitch. So another 2 groups. So at the end it's gonna be a little bit different because we need to work 3 groups of 2 double crochets together, so 2 chain 3 spaces as well. Then chain of 3 and we have to go to the next chain 5 space. Now we need to repeat treble crochet, chain 2, treble crochet, chain 2, and we need to make another 6 treble crochets. So after our last chain 3, we have to work slip stitch at the top of our double crochet, chain 2, we need to skip. Now we are going to start round 28. I am exactly at the top of the first group of 2 double crochets together. So we are going to start with chain of 2 as a first part of the double crochet. Then at the top of the next group we have to work 1 double crochet. So this is our 2 double crochets together again. So at the end of our round we need to skip chain 2 and work slip stitch in our first double crochet. Chain of 3. Now we are going directly to the first treble crochet and we have to work 2 double crochets, 1 and 2. Then in chain 1 space, chain 2 space, 1 double crochet, double crochet in next treble crochet, double crochet in next chain space, double crochet in next treble crochet, and now we've got the third chain space. So this is the center one and here we need to work 2 double crochets. Double crochet in next treble crochet, double crochet in chain 1, double crochet in next treble crochet, double crochet in next chain 1, so this is actually the last one, in next chain 2 space. And in our last treble crochet we have to work 2 treble crochet. So into the first one and into the last we need to work 2 double crochets. In our first and second chain 2 space we are working 1 double crochet, into the third one 2 double crochets, and into the fourth and fifth 1 double crochet as well. So in total we've got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14 double crochets. Now chain of 3. And we have to work first part of double crochet at the top of the first group of 2 double crochets together and first part of the double crochet at the top of the second one. Now we've got 3 loops, we can finish the stitch. So at the end this is going to be exactly the same as we've done in our previous round because we've got 3 groups of our 2 double crochets together, so we have to work in exactly the same way as we've done in our previous round. So first 2 double crochets together, then chain 3, then we have to go back to the same stitch, another 2 double crochets together, chain 3, and we have to start from the same stitch. So we should have 2 groups of 2 double crochets together at the end. So now we've got 1, then chain of 3, and we are going to repeat our pattern. So in our first treble crochet we need to work 2 treble crochets, then 1 treble crochet in chain 2 space, in next treble crochet, in next chain 2 space, and then in next treble crochets, 2 treble crochets in third chain space, and then 1 in each stitch apart from our last treble crochet. So in the last treble crochet we need to work 2 double crochets as well, so exactly as we've done here, so we should have 14 double crochets. Now we are going to start round 29. So our round we need to start with by making slip stitch in our first 3 chain stitches, then slip stitch in first double crochet. Now chain of 3 as a double crochet, then we need to work chain of 2 as a chain 2 space. Now we have to skip first double crochet into the second, chain 2. Then we have to skip next double crochet into the second, chain 2. Then we have to skip next double crochet into the second. So far we've got 4 double crochets and 3 chain 2 spaces. We had to skip 3 double crochets, but because we are exactly in the middle, now we are going to make another chain of 2 and double crochet in next double crochet. So we are not skipping, but we have to work 2 double crochets, one next to the other. From now, chain of 2, and we have to continue. So first of all, we need to skip first double crochet into the second, chain 2, skip first one, double crochet into the second, chain 2, then we have to skip first one and double crochet into the second. So on the right side, we had to skip 3 stitches, and on the left side we need to skip 3 stitches as well. So in the center we've got 2 double crochets, in a total 8 double crochets, 7 chain 2 spaces, and now we need to work chain of 3, then we are going to skip our 3 chain stitches, 2 double crochets together and another 3 chain stitches, and we have to make double crochet in first double crochet, and from now we need to repeat what we've done from the beginning. So now again, 8 double crochets, we have to skip 6 double crochets in the meantime. We've got 7 chain 2 spaces, and make sure that you've got 2 double crochets in the middle as well. We are going to start the last one around, around 30, and we have to make slip stitch in our first chain stitch, then slip stitch into the chain space, chain 1, and single crochet. Now chain of 3 in our next double crochet, so just after our chain space, we have to work first part of the double crochet, then into the chain 2 space we have to work 2 double crochets, but only the first part, so 1 and then another 1, 2. So we are working only through first 2 loops. The same we need to work in next double crochet, first 2 loops. Now we've got 5 loops and we can finish the stitch. So we've done 4 double crochets together. Now chain of 3, single crochet in next chain space, chain 3, then we need to work another group of 4 double crochets together. So first one into the double crochet, then next 2 into chain 2 space, 1 and 2, and next one into the next double crochet. Now we've got 5 loops, we can finish the stitch, and again chain of 3, single crochet in next chain space, chain 3, then into the double crochet we have to work first part of the double crochet, into the chain 2 space, 2 first parts of the double crochet, and into the next double crochet, 1 double crochet. When we've got 5 loops, we need to finish the stitch. So chain of 3, single crochet in our last chain 2 space. So as you can see, we just started with single crochet, then we've done in each second chain space actually group of 4 double crochets together, and single crochets in each second as well. Now we need to work chain of 2, single crochet in chain space, chain of 2, and then we need to make single crochet in our first chain 2 space. So from now actually we are going to repeat what we've done before, so we are going to start with chain 3, and then 4 double crochets together. So the first one into the double crochet, the next two into the chain 2 space, and the last one in next double crochet. Then chain 3, single crochet in next chain space, then again 4 double crochets together. So exactly the same as we've done here. A little bit different we've got at the end when we've got 2 chain 5 spaces. After single crochet, instead of chain of 2, we need to work chain 3, then single crochet, and another chain 3. The rest is staying exactly the same. So after our last chain 2 and single crochet, we have to work slip stitch in our first single crochet, then we can fasten off and cut the yarn, and that's it. So as I said at the beginning of our work, this project is very, very tight. So as you can see, it's waving so far. So as you saw on the picture, is lying actually flat, so we need to block this project. So for blocking, I am using spray for hairspray, and it's gonna be much better. So thank you for staying to the end of this tutorial, and see you in the next one. Have a nice day.